Yes, ma'am. It's been, you know, with only making $25,000 for our campaign, it's been very difficult to get our name out. And it's just extremely challenging as a third-party candidate with what how we're viewed, that we're not viable. I hear it all the time that you're a libertarian, you're not a Republican or a Democrat, you're never going to make it, you're never going to do it. And I haven't spent my time just pounding the phones and raising money, because we want money out of politics. I want money out of politics. And I thought to myself, you know what, if I can make just enough noise, just enough that I can get onto a stage like this and meet people and let them hear my message, that it's going to resonate with them. They know the difference in authenticity in somebody that clearly, I'm not a polished candidate or politician. I'm just a guy that wants better for my state, and that's resonating every single place that I go. If I meet with two people, I'll meet with two people. I call voters or potential voters as I'm traveling the state. I say, hey, if you want to talk to me, send me your number. And they'll send it to me on Facebook. I answer the messages and I call them. People are so tired, they're fed up. You saw the demonstration that my opponents put on, and they just went back and forth. That is a clear example of what politics has been in our country for entirely too long, and they want different.
You said you wanted to get the government out of pensions. It's a little fuzzy for me. Can you explain what that means and what kind of obstacle that would face given the Constitution the way it is?
Certainly. You know, the greatest obstacle, of course, is that constitutional amendment. I think the first step that we should do, and I'm surprised that they haven't done it yet, is to open it up so that all statewide employees could go ahead and begin opting into what the state university retirement system has offered its employees for over 20 years. Why haven't we done that? Why haven't we been just some common sense and sent some good positive messages to the credit rating agencies that, you know what, look, we've made some poor choices with our pensions, we're going to move forward. The General Assembly could pass legislation. They could make it so that all state employees could begin to opt into that. We do have that constitutional obligation to current and previous state employees, and it's going to be hard. Okay, there's no easy answer here. $130 billion. I don't even know what $1 billion looks like. I bought my suit at Macy's. I mean, you know, J.B. Pritzker's got over $3 billion that he's worth. They have no clue or understanding what it is to come from where we come from and where we have to work and to strive every single day. I don't have all of the answers, Mark. I wish that I did. I don't.
Mr. Kashman, you state your, how do you stand on immigration reform? Do you support any type of immigration reform here in our state?
You know what? I want to be the adult in the room that unfortunately I didn't feel I was presented that opportunity adequately when you posed a question earlier down there. And so thank you for asking me. Here's where I stand on it. Number one, I'd like to kind of go back and look at DACA recipients. I think that we should take an approach that I heard from Rand Paul to go ahead and take those DACA recipients and begin transitioning a percentage of them each year that doesn't count towards our overall immigration numbers. I think it's common sense. I think it's pragmatic. And I agree that, you know what, look, we're a nation founded on immigrants. Pretty much all of us, except for my very close friends that are Native Americans, you know, that I spend a great deal of time with. We are a nation of immigrants, but what we see and what we hear every day is the demonization of men and women and families seeking just a better life. That's all that they're seeking. I believe that we could expand some sort of a work visa. I want to take those immigrant communities that are afraid to go to the police because of the high crime, because they don't want to get deported. I want them to feel comfortable in this country while at the same time working with Donald Trump, working with that administration to tighten up national security, to tighten up our borders, and I'll do what I can where I can, but I'll tell you what I will not do, and I've taken a lot of flack for this. As a libertarian, because of my conservative leanings, I've taken a lot of flack when I said that what they were doing at the border was wrong, and I stand by that. I would never, ever dream of separating families. That bothered me, you know, to my core, because that's what I fight for. I fight for families, and I would never do that to them. And our administration has worked entirely too slow on that on a federal level, on a state level. You know what? A lot of these men and women, they have businesses, they own homes, they rent. They're paying virtually every bill that we are. and they just want a better life for their families, and I can't hate them for that. But at the same token, we can't encourage illegal immigration either. But I will work with the administration because I want to see people like a good friend of mine stationed at Naval Station Great Lakes. He's been in the military for over 21 years, and he's been trying for over 4 years to get his wife here from Jamaica. That's unacceptable. And we've seen veterans get deported for victimless crimes. I'm opposed to that. We're talking about victimless crimes, and a lot of these veterans that, and there's not, I'm not saying there's a lot, that there's some huge number, but even one is too many for me. For somebody who stepped up and served their country and very often suffered it life and limb for this nation, and then they got deported because they were using an illicit substance? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. We can find much more common ground, but it really takes you guys asking good questions, us sitting down together, and, you know, getting past just the partisan BS that we see. I mean, it was just, you know, frankly, it was embarrassing. And I was, you know, partially ashamed that I had to stand up there and just watch it and be a part of that. That is the very thing why I'm running, because it's not moving our state forward in a positive way. It's not doing right by our families, because that is all that's happening. We're divided. We are so divided.